Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 9.2 in the module Game Theory. The topic for this discussion is, in the game theory, we are going to discuss the 2% zero-sum game without saddle point. And we will be using arithmetic method to solve such a problem. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the 2% zero-sum game with saddle point. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the game without saddle point. So, the topic 2% zero-sum game without saddle point. When there is no saddle point on the payoff matrix of a game problem, it indicates that the players cannot use pure strategy for their play. So, when you have saddle point, there is pure strategy for a player A. Out of the various strategies available, he will be using any one of the strategy throughout the game. Similarly, for player B, out of the number of strategies available, he will be using any one of the strategies throughout the play. So, single strategy will be used, that is called as pure strategy for player A and B. When there is no saddle point, the pure strategy is not possible. So, in that case, they have to apply different strategy at correct proportion of time to optimize his loss or gain. So, out of the number of strategies available, they have to use the strategies in different proportion of time. And this kind of technique is called as mixed strategies method. So, in the mixed strategies method, what are the steps to solve the problem? So, first step, confirm that there is no saddle point for the in the problem. So, we have to search for the saddle point. The technique what we used earlier, we have to find the minimax and the maximum value. So, then we have to see that the minimax and maximum value are not equal. When they are equal, there is a saddle point. They are not equal, so there is no saddle point in the problem. Reduce the matrix by using the dominance rule. So, there are two rules. One is dominance rule for row. For the every row in the dominating rows must be greater than or equal to corresponding values in the dominated row. So, that we identify dominating row and dominated row. So, every value in the dominating row must be greater than or equal to the corresponding values in the dominated row. In that case, delete the dominated row. So, we have to delete the dominated row. Dominance rule for the column. Every value in the dominating column must be less than or equal to the corresponding values of the dominated column. So, here again, delete the dominated column. So, these are the two rules, dominance rule for row and the column. And reduce, if the step 3, if the reduced to, if the matrix is reduced to 2 by 2 matrix, obtain the solution by arithmetic method. So, if the matrix is reduced to 3 by 3 matrix, obtain the solution by matrix method, approximate method or linear programming method. Step number 5. If the matrix is reduced to 2 by n or m by 2 matrix, use graphical method to find the optimal strategies and use the arithmetic method to solve the problem. So, in this lecture, we will be using arithmetic method. In the next lecture, we will be using the graphical method. And in the next fourth lecture, we will be using the matrix method for solving the game problem. So, we will take example number 3. Obtain the solution for the following game by arithmetic method. So, there are two players, player A and player B. Player A, he got two strategies A1 and A2. Player B, he got two strategies B1 and B2. So, the game, the cell values are 3, 1, 2, 4. Now, we have to solve the game by arithmetic method. So, step 1, we have to search for the saddle point. So, the matrix is written here once again, B1, B2, A1, A2, so 3, 1, 2, 4. Now, we have to search for the saddle point. So, among the minimum value of the row, we have to write the minimum value of the row in the third column. So, 3, 1, the minimum value is 1, 2, 4, the minimum value is 2. Similarly, for the column 3, 2, the maximum value of the column. So 3, 2, the maximum value is 3, and 1, 4, the maximum value is 4. Why we are using the minimum value of the row and maximum value of the column? For the player A, if he is playing with strategy A1, we assume that player A is playing with the strategy A1. Now, when the player B is playing with B1, A1 will gain 3 rupees. If the player B is playing with B2, player A will gain 1 rupee. So, strategy A1, the gain is either 3 or 1. So, out of the two values, one value, the minimum value is 1. So, we do not know, the player A do not know which strategy the player B is going to use. But based on the value, cell value, so player A is assured a minimum of the value, so to 1. So, 1 rupee gain is minimum value that is assured. Similarly, for A2, or the strategy A2, so when the player B is playing with B1, the gain will be 2 rupees. When the player B is playing with B2, the gain is 4 rupees. The player A does not know which strategy he is using, the opponent is using, but the minimum assured gain is 2 rupees. So, that is why we are using the 2 here. Similarly, for the column B, player B is playing with B1, player A either playing with A1 or A2. If the player A is playing with A1, the loss will be 3 rupees. If the player A is playing with A2, the loss will be 2 rupees. So, for the player B, the maximum loss, out of these two, the maximum loss is going to be 3 rupees. So, that is why we write the maximum of the column, which is 3. Similarly, for the B2, the maximum value is 4. Now, we have to search for maximum of the minimum value. So, 2 is the maximum of the minimum value. And here, minimum of the maximum value. So, 3 is the minimum of the maximum value. So, these two values, maximin and minimax, maximin and minimax, they are not equal. So, there is no saddle point. Right? So, if there is saddle point, the corresponding strategies are the pure strategy. So, that is what we discussed earlier. There is no saddle point here. Now, we have to solve by arithmetic method. Again, the solution is given in the table. This is the matrix. The A1, A2, B1, B2, 3, 1, 2, 4. Now, we have to find the difference. So, difference, first row, the difference is 3, 1, the difference is 2, and write the value in the second row. Similarly, second row, the difference is 2, 4, 2 is the difference, write the value in the first row. Right? So, that both values are equal, but the method is 3, 1, the difference is 2, you have to write here in the second row. 2, 4, the difference is 2, you have to write here in the first row. Similarly, here for the column, 3, 2, the difference is 1, we have to write in the second column here. So, 3, 2, 1 in the second column. 1, 4, the difference is 3, so we have to write in the first column. So, the total value is 4. Again, remember, the total of these two values should be equal. Then only we can solve by arithmetic method. If the values are not equal, then you have to go to the next method, matrix method, to solve the problem. Now, so the player A is using A1, 2, A2, 2. So, the total value is 4. So, the player A is using strategy A1 for 2 by 4 time. Right? Player A2 for 2 by 4 time. Player B is playing with B1 for 3 by 4th of the time. And B2, 1 by 4th of the time. So, the time sharing. So, the proportion of the time by which the player A is playing with A1 is 50% of the time, A2 with 50% of the time. Similarly, player B is playing with B1 for 75% of the time. So, player B2, strategy B2 is playing with 25% of the time. So, the objective of the player A to maximize his gain. The objective of the player B to minimize his losses. So, for the player A to maximize his gain, the strategies are 50% of both strategy A1 and A2. For the player B, to minimize his losses, 75% of the time he is used the B1 and 25% of the time he is used the B2 strategy. Now, how to calculate the value of the game? When the player A is playing with A1, so A1 is the strategy. So, 3 into 3 by 4 plus 1 into 1 by 4. So, 3 into 3 by 4 plus 1 into 1 by 4 is equal to 10 by 4. When the player A is playing with A2, So 2 into 3 by 4. So 2 into 3 by 4. 4 into 1 by 4. Again it is 10 by 4. Player B is playing with B1. So this is the strategy. B1 is a strategy. 3 into 2 by 4. 2 into 2 by 4. So 3 into 2 by 4 plus 2 into 2 by 4 equal to 10 by 4. When the player B is playing with B2, that is equal to 1 into 2 by 4, 4 into 2 by 4, again it is 10 by 4. So the strategies for A and B. So A, player A is using the first strategy for 2 by 4 time and the second strategy also by 2 by 4 time. And the player B is using first strategy for 3 by 4 time and second strategy for 1 by 4 time. And the value of the game equal to 10 by 4. That is the answer to the problem. We take another example. Example number 4. Solve the game whose payoff matrix is given by player A. He has got 3 strategies A1, A2, A3. Player B has got 3 strategies B1, B2, B3. And we have the matrix 172, 627, 516. So these are all the payoff values. Now first we have to check for the saddle point. So we repeat the matrix here again. And the minimum of the row is written here. So among the three values, minimum value is first row. Among the three values, minimum value is 1. In the second row, the minimum value is 2. In the third row, the minimum value is 1. And the maximum of the column, the first column, the maximum value is 6. Second column, the maximum value is 7217. And third column, the maximum value is 2767. Now we have to search for mini max. So mini max equal to 2. Minimum of the maximum value is 2. And the maximin. So, maximin is 2 and the minimax equal to 6 and these two values are not equal and there is no saddle point. So there is no saddle point. Now, we have to reduce the matrix by dominance rule. So, what do you mean by dominance rule? For deleting row A3, we are going to delete the row A3. The values of the row in A2, so what are the values? 6, 2, 7. Dominating, this is called as dominating row, are greater than the values of A3. So 6 is greater than 5, 2 is greater than 1, 7 is greater than 6. If the player A is playing with the strategy A3, his gain will be less. So instead of actually, he may use A2 or A3. Comparing with these two, if he is playing with the A3, his gain will be less than the playing with the A2. So he should not use throughout the game, he should not use A3 value, A3 row. So delete the row A3. So when you delete the row A3, the remaining table is this. A1, A2, B1, B2, B3. Now, deleting the column B3. So, column B3. The value in the column B1. So, B1 is 1 and 6. Dominating column are less than the values in the column B3. So, B3 is less. So when the player B is playing with the B1, when the player B is playing with the B3, his loss will be more comparing with the playing with the B1. So the objective of the player B is to minimize his losses. So he should not play with the B3 because he will be losing more money. So we have to delete the column B3. So if the player B is playing with the strategy B3, the loss will be more than playing with the strategy B1. So, the column B3 is deleted. So, B3, when you delete B3, and the remaining matrix is A1, A2, B1, B2, 1, 7, 6, 2. Now, the strategy for player A, either A1 or A2, not A3. For the player B, either B1 or B2, not B3. So, B3 is not at all used by the player B, and the A3 is not at all used by the player A. Now, we reduced it to 2 by 2 matrix, then we have to use the arithmetic method. So for arithmetic method, we repeat the table here. I have shown all the calculations here. So first row, the difference 17, the difference is 6. You have to write in the second row. Second row, the difference is 624. You have to write in the first row. Then the total is 10. For the column, the difference in the first column 615. You have to write here in the second column. 725 again. You have to write in the first column. So the total is 10. So the total of the two oddments are equal. So now we can go for the solution by arithmetic method. So if the sum is not equal, then we have to use the matrix method to solve the problem. So the time proportion for the player A, the strategy A1, 4 by 10. strategy A2, 6 by 10. Similarly, for the player B, B1, 5 by 10 and B2, 5 by 10. So, now the value of the game. When the player A is using A1, it is going to be 1 into 5 by 10, 1 into 5 by 10 plus 7 into 5 by 10 is equal to 40 by 10 equal to 4. When the player A is playing with A2, so 6 into 5 by 10 plus 2 into 5 by 10 is going to be 40 by 10 equal to 4 again. Then when the player B is playing with B1, so 6 B1, 6, 1, 6. So, 1 into 4 by 10 plus 6 into 6 by 10 equal to 40 by 10 equal to 4. When the player B is playing with B2, so 7 into 4 by 10, 2 into 4 by 10, 2 into 6 by 10 equal to 40 by 10 equal to 4. So, whatever the, we can calculate with any one of the strategy, but we have to understand that if we calculate with any of the strategy, the value of the game is going to be the same. And the strategies for the player A and B. For the player A, first strategy 4 by 10 of time, second strategy 6 by 10 of time, and third strategy is not at all used. For the player B, first strategy 5 by 10 of the time, second strategy 5 by 10 of the time, and third strategy not at all used. So, the value of the game equal to 4. We take another example to understand the arithmetic method. Example number 5, solve the game whose payoff matrix is given by we have 2 player A and B, and we have 3 strategy for each player. For the player A, A1, A2, A3. For the player B, B1, B2, B3. And the value of the strategies or the payoff matrix value are 2, 3, 0.5, 1.5, 2 into 0, and 0.5, 1 and 1. So, these are all the values in the payoff matrix. So, we find the solution. First, we have to find out the search for the saddle point. So, we repeat the matrix again and we calculate minimum of the row. So, 2, 3, 0.5, the minimum value is 0.5. For strategy A2, 1.520, the minimum value is 0. And A3, 0.511, the minimum value is 0.5. And the maximum of the column, so for the B1, 1.5, 0.52. For the B2, 3, 2, 1, the 3. For B3, 0.5, 0 and 1, the maximum value is 1. Now, we have to find the maximum of minimum value, 0.5 and minimum of maximum value, 1. So, the minimax value and maximum value, they are not equal and there is no saddle point in the problem. So, when there is no saddle point in the problem, next step, you have to reduce the matrix by dominance rule. So, this is the matrix once again. We repeat the matrix A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, 2, 3, 0.5, 1.5, 2, 0, 0.5, 1, 1. Now, the deleting the column B2. So, the column is to be deleted. Now, the values in the column B1, dominating column, are less than the values in the B2. So, B1, 2, B2, 3, 1.5, 2, 0.5, 1. So, B1 column, the values are less comparing with B2 column. When the player B is playing with the B2 column, the value is strategy B2, his loss will be more comparing with the playing with the B1. So, he should not use B2. He should not use B2. So, the player B plays with the strategy B2, the loss will be more than playing with the strategy B1. So, the column B2 is deleted. So, B2 is deleted. The remaining matrix is like this. A1, A2, A3, B1 and B3. We have the value. Now, deleting the row A2. So, the value of the row in the A1. So, A1, we compare A1 and A2. Dominating row are greater than the value of A2, dominated row. So, look at here A1, A2. So, 2, 1.5, 0.5, 1. So, if the player A is playing, the objective of the player A is increasing his gain. When he is playing with A2 instead of A1, his loss will be more. Sorry, he will gain, his gain will be less. So, the objective is he has to improve his, maximize his gain. So, he should not play with A2. So, instead of playing with A2, he has to play with A1. So, if the player A is plays with the strategy A2, his gain will be less than playing with the strategy A1. So, delete the row A2. So, A2 is deleted. So, remaining matrix is A1, A3, B1, B3. So, this is the cell values of the matrix. Now we have to solve by arithmetic method. So once again we repeat the table. You find the difference 2 minus 1.5. The difference is 2, 1.5 is 2.5 equal to 1.5. 0.5 1. The difference is 0.5. We have to find the difference, not subtracting. Remember. So we have to find the difference of the first row 2.5, 1.5. Write in the value in the second row 0.5 1. The difference is 0.5. You write here in the first row. Similarly for the first column B1 column 2 0.5 1.5 we write in the second column 0.5 1 we write in the 0.5 which we write in the first column. So this is the value augment value. Now we have to find out. So the total value is 2. So the sum of the augment are equal to 2. So we can use the arithmetic method to solve the problem. So the 0.5 divided by 2 equal to 0.25. 1.5 divided by 2 equal to 0.75. Similarly here 0.5 divided by 2 equal to 0.25. 1.5 divided by 2 equal to 0.75. Now the game value. So when the player A is playing with A1. So A1 is a strategy. 2 into 0.5 divided by 2 plus 0.5 into 1.5 divided by 2. Which is 1.75 divided by 2 equal to 0.875. Similarly playing with A3. 0.5. Into A3 is 0.5 into 0.5 divided by 2 plus 1 into 1.5 divided by 2 equal to 1.75 divided by 2 equal to 0.875. Player B is playing with B1. So B1 is the value 2 into 0.5 divided by 2 plus 0.5 into 1.5 divided by 2 equal to 1.75 divided by 2 equal to 0.875. Similarly, when the player B is playing with B3, 0.5 into 0.5 divided by 2 plus 1 into 1.5 divided by 2 equal to 1.75 divided by 2 equal to 0.875. So the value of the game with for calculating for any of the strategy, it is going to be 0.875. So the solution to the problem, the strategies for player A and B. For player A, first strategy 25% of the time, second strategy not at all used, third strategy 75% of the time. For the player B, first strategy 0.25, 25% of the time. Second strategy not at all used and the third strategy 0.75, that is 75% of the time, and the value of the game equal to 0.875. So we stop here. So we continue the lecture in the game theory. In the next lecture we continue with the graphical method, and these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You can refer to the book Operation Research for your better for more information in the subject, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe to the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification subject. We'll meet again in the next video lecture. Until then, bye.